Hello friends, topic of this video is Geography chapter Soil Resources. Let us have a look at its syllabus. It includes types of soil, alluvial, black, red and laterite, distribution, composition and characteristics such as color, texture, minerals and crops associated, soil erosion, causes, prevention and conservation. Do watch climate and water resource videos if you haven't watched yet. Those are also important. Let us have a look at different soils and their formation. Alluvial soil, black or regal soil, red soil, laterite soil. Alluvial soil is formed by deposition by flowing rivers. Black soil is formed by weathering of lava rocks. Red soil, it is formed by weathering of crystalline and metamorphic rocks. Laterite soil is formed due to leaching in areas of heavy rainfall. So let's start our question answers. First question, how are alluvial soils formed? Alluvial soils are formed by the sediments brought down by rivers. The rivers deposit very fine particles of soil called alluvium in their plains during the long course of their journey. Next question, mention two advantages of alluvial soil. Alluvial soil is light and porous, easily tillable. It is fertile soil as it is rich in minerals like potash and lime. It is suitable for growth of large variety of rabi and kharif crops. Why is soil valuable resource for India? Soil is an important resource as it supports large variety of flora and fauna. India is an agricultural country. Most of its population is dependent on agriculture. Progress of agriculture, forest, industries depends on soil. Hence, it is an important resource for India. Why is black soil considered productive soil? Black soil is fine textured, clayey, making it highly water retentive. Moisture retentiveness makes it suitable for dry farming. In dry season, it shrinks and develops cracks which help in aeration. It is rich in lime, iron and magnesium. It is very fertile in most of the places. It is suitable for cultivation of cotton, jowar, wheat, sugarcane, oilseeds, citrus fruits and vegetables. Give reason, different regions in India have different kinds of soil for agriculture. India is a vast region with varied natural environment. We find several physiographic regions and different types of climate. Therefore, a number of soil types have developed here. Next question, give reason, alluvial soils vary in texture. Alluvial soils are formed by deposition of load by river as it flows from upper to lower course. In the upper reaches of the river valley, soil is coarse. Soil particles are large and non-uniform. As we move further down the river valley, soil particles become smaller and uniform. Give reason, nearly all crops grow well in riverine soil. Riverine or alluvial soil is formed by deposit of load as river flows from its upper course to lower. It is light, porous and easily tillable. It is fertile as it is rich in minerals like lime and potash. It is suitable for growth of large variety of rabi and kharif crops. Give two characteristic features of the soil found most suitable for growing cotton and sugarcane in Maharashtra. The soil found most suitable for growing cotton and sugarcane in Maharashtra is black soil. It is fertile in most of the places. It is rich in lime, iron and magnesium. It is very clayey, therefore highly retentive of water. During dry season, black soil shrinks and develops white cracks which help in air circulation. Name one soil of volcanic origin commonly found in India. Name one crop widely grown in this soil. black soil, rigor soil or lava soil is formed by weathering of lava rocks. Crop widely grown in black soil is cotton, and other crops are sugarcane, tobacco, oilseeds. Name the process by which laterite soil is formed. This soil is formed due to atmospheric weathering of rocks under conditions of high temperature and rainfall, with alternating dry and wet periods. It is soil formed due to leaching in areas of tropical rainfall. Leaching is a process in which nutrients get percolated down below the soil due to heavy rainfall, thus leaving the topsoil infertile. This is also called desilication. Mention one disadvantage of the laterite soil. Laterite soil doesn't retain moisture, hence not fertile. It is acidic due to leaching of alkalis. Give reason. Deltic alluvium is more fertile than coastal alluvium. Deltic alluvium is more fertile than coastal alluvium as new layers are deposited every year during monsoon floods. Deltic alluvium consists of fine silt and clay, whereas coastal alluvium consists of lime nodules. Next question. Black soil is largely found in the Deccan Trap region. Black soil is in situ soil, that is found where they are formed. It is formed by weathering of volcanic rock formed by Deccan lava. Hence, black soil is largely found in the Deccan Trap region. Black soil is often referred to as cotton soil or rigor soil. Black soils are clayey, water retentive, rich in lime, iron, potash, etc. It is most suitable for cultivation of cotton. Hence, it is also called black cotton soil. State two subcategories into which alluvial soil is generally divided. Which one of them is superior to other and why? On the basis of its age, alluvial soil is generally divided into two types, khadar and bhangar. Bhangar or older alluvium is composed of lime nodules or kankar and is clayey in nature. Crops can be grown on it by adding manure. Khadar is composed of newer deposits. It is more fertile than bhangar as new layers are added to it year after year during monsoon floods. Which soil is suitable for growing coffee in Karnataka? Mention two characteristics of this soil. Soil suitable for growing coffee in Karnataka is laterite soil. Its characteristics are, here I am not giving two, I am giving more characteristics as they can appear in the question paper as give reason questions. So the characteristics are, it is of coarse texture, soft and friable. It is red in color due to presence of iron oxides. It is porous, poor in lime, magnesium and nitrogen. It does not retain moisture, hence not fertile. It is suitable for special crops like tapioca, cashew nuts, tea and coffee, etc. It is acidic in nature as alkalis are leached. It is considered suitable for building purposes. Give reason. Soils of Western Ghats are affected by wind erosion. A large part of Western Ghat lies in arid or semi-arid zone with less rainfall, less vegetative cover. Wind erosion occurs due to soil degradation. Name two states in India where rigor soil or black soil is found. Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat, Andhra Pradesh are the states where rigor soil is found. Besides cotton, which crops grow well in rigor soil? Besides cotton, the crops which grow well in rigor soil are cereals, oil seeds, citrus fruits, vegetables, tobacco and sugarcane. Give two points of difference between rigor and alluvial soil. Rigor soil, it is in situ soil, that is found at a place where it is formed. Alluvial soil, it is transported soil, that is alluvium deposited by the rivers. Formed by weathering of volcanic rocks formed by Deccan lava. Alluvial soil is formed by deposition of alluvium by the rivers. Name two states where red soil is found. Name two important crops grown in this soil. Red soil is found in Tamil Nadu, Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh. It is most suitable for growing vegetables, rice, ragi and tobacco. Give reason. Red soil is red in color and its color varies from yellow to brown. It is red in color due to presence of large amounts of iron oxides. The soil differs from place to place on the basis of parental rock material and climatic conditions. It looks yellow when it occurs in hydrated form. Mention two advantages and disadvantages of red soil. Advantages: it is rich in iron oxides. It is suitable for dry farming as it is formed in places with poor rainfall. It is not fertile but responds well to fertilizers. Disadvantages: it is poor in nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium and organic matter. It is porous, sandy, needs fertilizers and irrigation for cultivation. What is soil erosion? Name part of India where wind is the main agent of erosion, water is the main agent of erosion. Removal of top soil cover by water, wind and human activities is called soil erosion. Wind is the main agent of erosion in Rajasthan. Water is the main agent of erosion in Meghalaya. How does deforestation lead to soil erosion? Soil binds the roots of trees and plants together. Cutting down of trees exposes the soil to water and wind, which leads to soil erosion. State two methods of controlling soil erosion by running water. Two methods of controlling soil erosion by running water are construction of dams and plugging of gullies. Construction of dams. Rivers cause soil erosion. Dams are built in the upper course of the river to control soil erosion. Plugging of gullies. The gullies made in the soil are plugged with deposition of silt during heavy rains. Give two methods of preventing soil erosion. Terrace farming. In hilly areas, terraces act as bunds, preventing soil from being washed away by running water. Shelter belts. Farmers plant trees in several rows to prevent wind erosion. These are known as windbreaks. Next question. What is meant by soil conservation? Soil conservation means prevention of soil loss from erosion or prevention of reduced fertility of soil caused by overusage, acidification, salination or other types of soil contamination. Give reason. Water harvesting aids in soil conservation. Water is one of the agents of soil erosion. Water harvesting will prevent top layer of soil being washed away by the rainwater and percolation of nutrients in the soil, that is leaching. Hence, water harvesting helps in soil conservation. What are the characteristics of alluvial soil? Alluvial soil is formed by deposition of the river load as it flows from higher course to lower course. In upper course of the river valleys, soil is coarse, soil particles large and non-uniform. As we move further down, particles become smaller and uniform. It is light and porous, hence easily tillable. It is fertile as it is rich in minerals like lime and potash. It is suitable for growth of large variety of rabi and kharif crops. How is the man responsible for soil erosion? As the population increases, demand of land for human settlement increases. Cultivation, overgrazing by animals, improper techniques, deforestation, etc. leads to soil erosion on wide scale. Give different methods of preventing soil erosion. Different methods of preventing soil erosion are terrace farming, shelter belts, contour plowing, strip cropping, construction of dams, plugging of gullies, planting trees. Explain in brief the need for conservation of soil as a natural resource. There is an acute need to prevent soil erosion because of its adverse effects, which include loss of fertile soil together with its nutrients from the upper surface gradually leads to loss of soil fertility, and low agricultural productivity, lowering of water table and decreasing soil moisture, drying of vegetation, extension of arid lands leading to frequent droughts and floods, silting of river and canal beds, adverse effect on economic prosperity and cultural development. This is the last question of the video. Thank you for watching.